Hello friends. This video is dedicated to the wired version of the Acura H1 Zigbee dimmer. I have already discussed its wireless version previously, and you can find the link in the description. First, I want to clarify a very important point. This is not a classic TRIAC dimmer that physically controls the power supply to the load. Dimming is only logical, through automation, just like the wireless version I just mentioned. Why wires are needed and what else this device can do, more on that in my video. Before we start, as usual, please like this video so more people interested in smart home topics can find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Type of device: logical dimmer and 3-channel relay with energy monitoring. Model: Acura H1. Interface: Zigbee 3.0. Maximum power: total 2200 watts, current up to 10 amps. Operating temperature range: from 0 to 40 degrees Celsius. Relative humidity: from 0 to 95%. Size: 86 by 86 by 55.7 millimeters. Ecosystem: Acura Home. The device comes in a sturdy cardboard box with recognizable branding and the Acura logo. The front side also features a photo of the reviewed product. On the back side, you can see the device's parameters, which I have already mentioned, and the abundance of hieroglyphs indicates that this is a version for the Chinese market. Inside, I found the dimmer, 2 screws for mounting, and a small manual. The manual, by the way, is also in Chinese. If you want to read it, you can use a camera and Google Translator, but in this video, I will try to cover all the nuances and features. On the outside, it is indistinguishable from the wireless version. It has a square panel with a round rotary knob in the center. However, from the back, it looks like a 3-channel switch with a neutral line. The internal part, meant for the junction box, is quite bulky, and the backside also indicates the model number and maximum power. There are 5 screw terminals, incoming phase and neutral, and 3 outgoing lines for connecting the load. Like other devices in this series, the entire top cover with the rotary knob is removable. The grooves on the lower side are used for this purpose. This design allows them to be combined using special frames, arranging them in a single line. I'm talking about the Acura H1M, Pro Series, S1 panels, air quality monitor, thermostat, and so on. These devices do not fit into a round junction box. If you already have such boxes installed in your wall, you'll need to trim them and increase the internal space. However, it is better to use square junction boxes, 86 by 86 millimeters, with screw mounts. For the device to work, both phase and neutral need to be connected. I made a small test stand where I connected a regular socket to the first relay channel, which can be used to connect loads. Let's move on to the logical part and start with the standard control system. Acura Home, China region. Here, I am using the Acura M2 Zigbee gateway. We go into the mode for adding new devices, and in the list, we search for the dimmer by name. To put the device into pairing mode, you need to press and hold the rotary knob for about 10 seconds until the LED underneath it blinks red. There were no issues with the connection. The dimmer was detected and connected. Several cards appeared in the system, one of which corresponds to the rotary knob, and 3 others correspond to each of the relay channels. Each of these can be given its own name, assigned an icon, and set a location. In the device list, it appears as a single line. Immediately after connecting, the firmware was checked and updated. The current version as of the review date is 156. Object control panel. As I mentioned, the review device is displayed as 4 cards, but the plugin for all of them is the same, general. It resembles the switch plugin, but without the graphical display of each relay channel. At the bottom of the screen is the energy monitoring panel. It is common and counts by input. By default, pressing the button turns all 3 relays on and off at once. Let's look at the main device settings. Most options are standard: name, location, gateway to which it is connected, firmware version, signal level, and so on. In the device card menu, you can change the appearance of all cards, the dimmer, and each of the switches. The most interesting menu here is the settings. It starts with a parameter that allows you to display the selected relay channels on the main plugin screen. This makes it almost indistinguishable from the Switch plugin. Channel Management Menu. By default, as we have already tested, a single click controls all three outputs. This is not automation. It is an internal setting. This can be customized as desired. For example, setting separate controls or removing it entirely to control only via automation. State Memory Mode. When activated, all three relay channels will return to the same status they were in before the power was turned off. Sensitivity setting for the rotary knob, which is set to low by default, and control of the indicator under the rotary knob, it will turn off at night. The MarsTech menu, which attentive viewers might recognize from my videos about the wired switches of the H1M, Z1, and Z1 Pro series, allows you to set the type of load for each relay channel. By default, it is set to normal, which means regular on-off operation. The smart load option allows control of Zigbee lights connected to the same gateway. For testing, I am using an Acura T1 bulb. Despite the menu stating that the controlled lamp must be connected to the same relay channel, this is not actually necessary. I connected the bulb to the second channel, which was reflected in this menu. The third type of load is pulse, with the ability to set the pulse length. With a single press, the first channel operates in normal mode, supplying power to an incandescent bulb. A double press turns the Zigbee bulb on and off, while the relay for the channel it is linked to remains constantly on. This linkage works directly and is not dependent on the gateway, which is currently physically disconnected. Control continues to function normally. In pulse mode, the relay also remains constantly closed, supplying power to the load. Upon pressing, it turns off for the set interval and then turns back on, simulating the operation of a return switch. Returning to the plugin, this is how it looks if you enable the display of each relay in the settings menu. If a load is connected, the current power and energy consumption are displayed below. There is also a history of interactions with the rotary knob and an energy usage graph. Further down is the group creation menu. It allows you to combine several relay channels and create an additional object that allows simultaneous control of them. Let's move on to the automations that our reviewed device can participate in. Starting with the if section, which includes triggers or conditions, there are 9 available options. First, for the relays, the triggers are turn on and turn off, followed by conditions if on and if off. Then there are triggers for the rotary knob: single press, double press, hold, rotate, and rotate with press. For the relay-related options, you can select from the 3 available channels. Unlike the previously discussed smart load mode, automation depends on the gateway's functionality. In this example, the light bulb will turn on and off with a single press. For rotate and rotate with press, only smooth adjustment actions, such as brightness and color temperature, are available. This depends on the device you want to use in the automation. Currently, a single press not only switches the state of the first relay, supplying power to the incandescent bulb, but also controls the Zigbee bulb through automation. Brightness adjustment by turning the knob. At a low sensitivity level, it changes slowly, and at a high level, it changes faster. For the actions section, it is much simpler. There are options to turn on, turn off, and toggle the state of each relay channel. In this section, we will check compatibility with other systems that also use gateways. Let's start with Acura Home, but the Europe region. The gateway used is Acura E1, with the firmware current as of the test date. Searching for the device by model number yielded no results. However, the gateway can be put into pairing mode by selecting any Zigbee device, which I did. Unfortunately, I could not connect the dimmer, even after several attempts. I conclude that it only works in the China region. Next up is Mahome, trying the China region. The gateway is Xiaomi Gateway 3, with the firmware current as of the test date. This story is the same as Acura Home, Europe region. There is no direct link to the device, so you need to choose something else. Unfortunately, I could not connect the dimmer here either. At this point, I remembered that I had not tested the device with Apple HomeKit. For this, I had to reconnect it to the Acura M2 gateway in the China region, which went smoothly. This gateway acts as a bridge to HomeKit, and all compatible devices connected to it automatically appear there. However, in this case, it did not work either. The gateway appears in HomeKit, but the dimmer does not. Now let's move on to alternative control systems, starting with the local smart home hub Sunoff iHost. I'll leave a link to the review in the description below the video. The firmware version at the time of testing is 200, which was released recently. If I find anything interesting while studying the changes, I'll make another video on this topic. iHost is equipped with its own Zigbee coordinator, which allows it to connect devices directly, even from different manufacturers. The Acura H1 connected successfully, so let's see what is available here. In the general list, a panel with the new device appeared, displaying its model. But unfortunately, that's all. There is no control, not even basic relay switches. All that is available is the ID, manufacturer name, and model. The wired Acura H1 dimmer is not supported on the current firmware version. Next, let's check if the dimmer can be used with Home Assistant. I'm conducting tests on a fanless mini PC based on Intel N4000, link in the description. We'll start with the standard integration for Zigbee devices, ZHA. A USB Zigbee stick with SkyConnect firmware is used as the coordinator, and those interested in details can find the link in the description as well. Starting the pairing process, the dimmer is detected and added to the system. It shows that several control objects have been defined. Here's what was found. All three relay control channels, current power sensors, and energy consumption. Firmware version, device temperature, and an identification button. It should help determine the needed device among several identical ones. Now for the bad news. Energy monitoring does not work. An incandescent bulb with a power of over 70 watts is connected to the first channel. I waited for 30 minutes, but the sensor data did not update. Furthermore, there is no way to configure actions for pressing the rotary knob. The default mode operates, controlling all three relay channels at once. Events like single press, double press, hold, and rotations do not appear in the system. In ZHA, it functions just as a three-channel relay without energy monitoring. And the last system for today is Zigbee 2 MQTT. The test was conducted on version 1.39.0 using a Zigstar LAN with the CC2652P as the coordinator. Good news, support is available out of the box, with no need for external converters. Another point I haven't mentioned yet is that in a Zigbee network, the wired Acura H1 model acts as a router, meaning it can relay data from other network nodes, increasing its capacity and coverage. Let's move on to the exposure page. First up is the device temperature, which is data from the internal sensor. Then there is the power outage counter, state memory, operating mode, and several readings from the rotary knob. Next are the energy monitoring sensors, energy, voltage, current, power. The action field is where events from pressing and rotating the knob should appear, along with the three relay channels. Energy monitoring works. Here is the data with the light bulb on. After a while, the energy sensor will update as well. State memory also works. When the switch is active, after power is restored, all relays will return to their state before the power was cut. However, attempting to change the mode results only in an error. The fields where values related to the rotary knob should appear remained at zero for me. The device also appears in the OTA menu, but given that I already updated it in Acura Home, there are no new firmware updates, as expected. In Home Assistant, the device is added through the MQTT integration. Here we see all the same values as on the exposure page. Initially, not all values are displayed on the panel. 8 entities are hidden. To view them, you need to click on this link. Among others, there are two energy monitoring sensors, current and voltage. To display them on the panel, click on the desired sensor and then go to its settings. You need to enable the activation switch. About a minute later, it will appear on the panel. Similarly, sensors that you do not need can be deactivated to avoid overloading the system. A single press on the rotary knob generates a single event, but also switches the state of all three relays. This cannot be disabled at the moment. Double click, hold, and the subsequent release event do not switch the relays and can be used in automations. Rotating the knob consists of a sequence of events: start rotation, release, end rotation. pressing and rotating the knob look similar. Overall, as of the testing date, using the device in Zigbee 2 MQTT is inconvenient, mainly because you cannot decouple relay control from pressing the rotary knob. The reviewed device essentially represents a hybrid switch with neutral and energy monitoring on three lines and a logical dimmer. It's a rather strange combination, especially considering the default mode for a single press on the rotary knob. In my opinion, it is more convenient to use separate switches and wireless dimmers, placing them where needed and on the required number of lines, especially for users of alternative control systems. I hope this review helps you make the right choice and avoid spending money on useless devices. That's all for now. I would appreciate your likes as they help promote the video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss other tutorials and reviews, subscribe to my channel. In the video description, you will find all the necessary links to other devices I mentioned, to stores where you can order such a dimmer, to my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and a group for smart home discussions. Join us, it will be interesting. Thanks for watching, see you next time. Peace to everyone.